Welcome to PNC Stadium, where the Houston Dash hosts Gotham FC for this Wednesday NWSL showdown. Alongside former Manchester United keeper Gary Bailey, I'm Maura Sheridan. Glad to have you here with us. Now, these are two teams, Gary, on very different paths this NWSL season. Houston right now in second place in the NWSL standings, trying to keep that spot so they can get a bye in the NWSL playoffs. And for Gotham, second to last in the standings right now. And honestly, they just need to start picking up 3 points.
Yep, desperate times for Gotham. Houston 4 unbeaten. That's 1 draw and 3 wins, so fantastic form. Onumanu comes back in to try and help Gotham stop this 4 straight losses slide. They've conceded 15 goals, so a big task ahead for Onumanu and company.
Well, you see Houston in the traditional orange kits and in their road whites. That's Gotham. Referee is Alex Billiter today as we get set to go. First kick underway. It's going to be Houston ball to start. Back and forth with Shea Groom. And immediately an early touch for Midge Purse, who intercepts.
Yeah, new beginnings as well for Gotham, with Hugh Menzies now in charge. And whenever there's a new coach coming in, there's normally a bump, there's normally some excitement. He's made 3 changes, and you just wonder if maybe this is what the team needed, some fresh injection of ideas. And obviously after Scott Parkinson left, so we'll see whether it's going to work or not.
Well, Menzies was announced on Saturday, then he had his first match with the team against OL Reign in Seattle. So what a welcome to the NWSL. Ultimately lost that game 4-1. Only one team, Houston, has beat OL Reign at home.
I think you can let him off on that first game and just say, look, he didn't have time to even, you know, settle in and get to meet everybody. Now he has made 3 changes, so it's beginning to take a little bit more shape as to what he wants. He will want to, he said if he gets to the playoffs, it'll be gravy. So he doesn't expect the team to shoot up the table. He does expect them to perform better than they have been.
It's going to be very difficult for Gotham to shoot up the table. They do have some games in hand. They played 15 compared to, say, Houston that's played 15, but it's still a very long path to get there. Like you said, one step at a time for Menzies taking over after Parkinson was let go. Gene cuts it back. One thing to note about this Gotham lineup is that, well, they have a lot of excused absences. Ashlyn Harris and Allie Krieger both on an excused absence after the birth of their son, Ocean. And then Caprice Didasco is also kind of a late addition to that list. So Didasco will not get the start today, and it appears Ellie Jean is in at that right back spot.
Yep, Ellie Jean to right back. Imani Dorsey comes in. She goes to left back in place of Caprice Didasco. Ife Onumanu comes in. Paige Monahan drops to the bench. And Jennifer Cujo in midfield, the only six. They have been playing with 2 sixes. Now it's just Jennifer Cujo. Taryn Torres goes to the bench.
Well, you saw Menzies there, and that's something that he pointed out to us in the coaches' call this week, is that we only want to go with the 1 6. It's going to be Cujo.
Comfortable save there. Yeah, he wants them to be more on the front foot. He says, in his opinion, they were playing out of character in the past. They were playing long ball. He said they want to go from 2 sixes, which is basically 2 defensive midfielders. There he is. Hugh Menzies, they want to go from 2 defensive midfielders just to 1 and push the likes of McCall Zaboni and Christy Mewers, push them up, get them attacking, get them supplying ball to the front three.
Oh, see how that shakes out again. Quite the challenge here against Houston as Zerboni gets an interception. Sophie Schmidt in the midfield. Again, Houston, top of the table right now. Back to Jane Campbell. On a 4-game unbeaten streak under interim head coach Juan Carlos Amoros. So we're seeing 2 interim coaches go head-to-head. It's been quite the start for Amoros. It's been an incredible start, I should say. 3 straight wins until the Racing Louisville match last Friday. Ended in a scoreless draw. And honestly, Houston had so many opportunities to win that game and just weren't able to figure it out. And Racing Louisville, again, just playing behind Katie Lund, who has saved them multiple times this year. So Lund had 9 saves in that game.
Here's Juan Carlos Amoros, formerly of Real Betis and Tottenham Hotspur in England. Mind you, his team did hold Louisville to 0 shots on target last Friday. So yes, they didn't score. It ended his running streak, but defensively they were very, very solid, Houston Dash.
Yeah, an easy day at the offense for Jane Campbell. She's probably not going to face that again this year as Ebony Salmon gets tangled up with Mandy Freeman. Free kick on the way for Houston.
And that's somewhere where Gotham have to tighten up at the back. Mandy Freeman, Estelle Johnson, Ellie Jean, and Marnie Dorsey. They've been leaking goals a little bit too easily, and against O.R. Rain gave away a few personal errors at the back. If they can cut those out with the forward line they have of Taylor Smith, Mitch Purse, and Effie Onamanu, they could cause Houston Dash a few problems.
Well, these two teams did play July 31st, and it was a very lopsided score. Final score was 4-2. Paige Monahan scored, and then the rest was pretty much Houston as Ebony Salmon tracks in. Here comes a corner for the Dash.
Ebony Salmon in fantastic form. Mind you, Mitch Purse did score a fantastic second goal for Gotham in that particular match. So to watch out for her. She's a fantastic talent, Mitch Purse.
It does feel like if Gotham can get Purse the ball, I know it's simple, but she seems to be their most or their strongest offensive player, and so you get the feeling that good things will happen if Purse gets touches, but that didn't happen really against O.L. Rain, and that was kind of the secret sauce there. Plus Megan Rapinoe had herself a day. Off the corner, Beatos in a crowded area, so they will make the grab.
Good catch. Beatos under a lot of pressure there, clean hands and able to knock that ball way down the pitch. And just looking at Houston Dash, just two changes to their side that were held 0-0 in that match you mentioned against Racing Louisville. Elizabeth Eddy comes in for Ryan Garris, who drops to the bench, and Emily Ogle in for Marissa Vigiano.
Nichelle Prince takes a shot and saved by Beatos. Early look from Nichelle Prince, who has 5 goals this year with Houston.
Decent save from the goalkeeper, as expected, but confidence there from Nichelle Prince. And when the ball comes across, they've got so much attacking flair, Houston Dash, with Ebony Salmon and Maria Sanchez. These neat little touches. She's been allowed to shoot from 16 yards out. That's not the best defending there from Gotham, and lucky she didn't connect with that one.
Well, interestingly enough, only 1 goal from outside the box for Houston this year, so they tend to do better when they're obviously in the area. This is a Houston team that scored 26 goals this year. Got 3 penalty kicks, and 4 times they've scored 4 or more goals. Again, one of them against Gotham in July. Schmidt, a little shaken up after getting knocked in the boot. Christy Mewis tries to turn. Ogle looking to rip it away, and Mewis stays strong. Purse, Onamanu. Iffy Onamanu was out with an illness for a couple of matches, and so they were very glad to have her back in the last game against O.L. Rain. Came in the 69th minute. 3 minutes later, she's getting an assist to Taylor Smith, and that was the only goal, really the only bright spot for Gotham in Seattle. It's not really a surprise if she's in the starting lineup.
Yeah, no, I think she's a fantastic player, Iffy Onamanu. Works well with Mitch Purse. Mitch Purse is the star. She's got the pace, she's got the ability. But Effie Onamanu can see where she is. She can slide her in with some very, very good assists. And then you throw in top of that Taylor Smith, who's been in really good form, got a goal against O.L. Rain and against Louisville this season already. I think you've got a very, very good front three. It's in defense where they've struggled in the past, Gotham.
Well, Freeman got in front of that. That is what Houston's going to try to do. Loft it up for Ebony Salmon. It's worked a lot this year. 6 goals for Salmon in her time with Houston. Schmidt. Elizabeth Eddy charging in, tries to break through. Zerboni with a tackle. Katie Nutton approaching 10,000 NWSL minutes as Katie Nutton. She's been so crucial for Houston this year. Played every single minute this season, of course. And she's got 82 clearances. That's a team high by far. Paired up with Prysock. You see her right there.
That's some good pressure there from Gotham for a moment. You thought they might get turnover ball, but Houston Dash come away with it.
Schmidt. Off to Sanchez.
Lovely switch up play by Sophie Schmidt.
4 assists for Maria Sanchez. This season runs right into Cujo. Back to Jacobs out in front. It's punched by Beatos.
good punch from the goalkeeper. She had to get that spot on there, because otherwise that would have been in the back of the net. And now it's twice the goalkeeper's come off the line, Michelle Bathos, to great effect.
Ogle, quick little reset here for Houston. Again, held scoreless against Racing Louisville.
Mind you, in that match, Racing Louisville, 0.012 expected goals. In other words, they didn't really, as we said, didn't even get one shot on target that entire match. And they just defended well. They were actually down to 10 men, Racing Louisville, for the whole second half. And still, Houston Dash couldn't find a way through. Just one of those days.
Prince tries to find Salmon first the other way. Right into Schmidt. Now Zerboni. Cujo. Taylor Smith. Again, Smith, Anumanu, and Purse have not really had the chance to play together, because Smith was picked up off waivers from North Carolina when Anumanu and Purse were on international duty. And then Purse came back, but Anumanu was not immediately healthy. So we only got that little taste of that trio against OL Reign. So now we're going to finally see him for a good chunk of this match.
And they are a fantastic front three. Eddie getting a word from the referee, because she was tugging and pulling and pushing. And referee Alex Pulitzer says, calm it down. But, you know, that's what I say. If they can be tight in defense, Gotham, the front three of Purse and Anumanu and Taylor Smith, and behind them, McCall Zerboni and Christy Mewis pushing forward from midfield, that is top, top class. You just got to stop conceding goals.
Well, Gotham has only scored 10 goals this year. Just trying to find some more consistency.
They've conceded 11 goals in their last three road games. And they've lost all three of those. So not been a happy time on their travels for Gotham.
Sanchez from Groom. Ogle. Pressure from Mewis, trying to get the swipe. Deflects, Prince off the pickup. Jean turns around, and then Prince, pretty obvious tug. And that will get it called back, Gotham ball.
Really had to give Jean back her top there, because pulling that hard. It's a good start from Gotham under a new coach, Hugh Menzies. You just obviously don't want to concede early. Bathos has had to come and deal with a couple of aerial threats. But other than that, they'll feel confident, and that's what the new coach is looking for. He's looking for them to play more on the front foot. He says you've got to play through the likes of Christy Mewis and McCall Zerboni. They're such quality midfielders. I think the new coach will be happy that what he's seeing is an improvement on what happened against OL Reign in their last match.
That was a complete dominant performance from OL Reign. There was times where we would go stretches without Gotham really getting into their attacking third for, you know, 20 to 30 minutes of that match. So things are looking a lot better. Jane Campbell picks one up off the bounce. Purse crashing in, trying to make some noise. Cujo. Again, just Cujo's third start this year. That lone six role for Gotham. Mewis stretches out. Zerboni, by the way, congrats to McCall Zerboni. Just passed 15,000 career minutes in the NWSL. Only Lou Barnes for OL Reign has more minutes than Zerboni.
Wow, that is incredible. 15,000 regular season minutes. That's a supreme professional who can put in those sort of numbers, remain fit, remain competitive, be chosen in the first team week after week. Brilliant.
Too far in front of Salmon, picked up by Bathos. Ebony Salmon had scored in all three wins prior to that draw against Racing Louisville. Just got two shots on target off in the last match and ended up being pulled out in the 83rd minute.
Well, to be fair to her, six goals in four
right.
matches.
She deserved a break.
Player of the month for July, you know. You're not going to score every game, and yes, you deserve the break, Ebony Salmon, but incredible form and great pace. Very similar, I think, to Mitch Purse in some ways. They're both fantastic players, but if you add in the pace they have, if they get on the last shoulder, if they can stand next to the center half and get decent ball played behind the back four, they can cause all sorts of problems.
Well, here comes Taylor Smith, full speed ahead, into the box, across to Purse, and it's just missed. What a great opportunity for Gotham.
Brilliant break, and that's exactly what they can do. Fantastic from Taylor Smith. The ball just literally had just a touch too much in it, but Zaboni helping with the build-up. But look at the options. There's near post on Amanu, far post Mitch Purse. Taylor Smith picks out the far post. It might have got a touch off a defender on the way. Have a look at Norton. I don't know if she got a touch or not, but just literally inches away from Mitch Purse scoring.
Started from Cujo. And that Houston defense just got burned lucky.
Very, very lucky. Quality front three, and that was the perfect way to play it. And I'm sure Hugh Menzies, the former Jamaica National World Cup coach, will be very excited by what he's seeing up front from Gotham at the moment.
And now Smith earns a free kick. Good position for this on the Gotham side.
Look, Reed, the referee said no more. And that was Eddie again. That's the second time that she's spoken to Elizabeth Eddy.
Yeah, again, Eddy getting the start at left back. Garris sometimes been in that spot because Alicia Chapman right now is out with a concussion. Well, I don't think we're going to see zero shots against Jane Campbell today. Purse gets set on this when you see Mewis, Smith, Zerboni, and then Anamanu. Looks like we'll trend towards that back post. From Purse, it's up to Anamanu, heads it down. Mewis can't get a shot off.
That's a fantastic free kick because she aimed for Anamanu at the far post, made sure Jane Campbell couldn't come for it. And Anamanu gets up, wins it, heads it down into the danger area, and nobody able to finish it off.
Cujo. Blazing forward. Cujo takes a shot and Campbell is forced to make a save. Jacobs keeps it in though. No corner coming for Gotham.
Oh, Cujo playing in that number six defensive midfield role and comes all the way up. It was absolutely brilliant. Look at that dribble from her as well. Stunning bit of play from Jennifer Cujo. And you're thinking maybe she's looking for someone to pass it off to, eyeing up on Amanu. Can she get there? And eventually goes, you know what, I'll just keep dribbling.
Well, Houston, back the other way. Sanchez in the area. Slice off to Salmon, back to Sanchez, has some time. Floats it in to Schmidt, up in the air. Beitos is able to just watch it bounce.
Schmidt not able to get a full header on that, but she did score in the previous match when they won 4-2 Houston Dash. But it was a golazo, if I remember correctly, right, yes, in the top corner. So Sophie Schmidt. And here's this little bit of skill again from Jennifer Cujo. It just keeps going. Good save from Jane Campbell in the end.
Zerboni. Anamanu. Taken away by Eddie. Does have a brace this year against North Carolina. And a win for Houston. Right before that international break in June. Schmidt. Yeah, to your point, it feels like whenever Sophie Schmidt does score, it's always a crazy goal, a very tough angle or something like that. Schmidt is obviously a very talented NWSL player. She was in the league in 2013, one of just a few players that can say that when the NWSL started. And then, of course, has had a incredible career on the Canadian national team side. It's actually one of just three players in Canada's history to score in three different decades. Christine Sinclair being one of those other players. No surprise there. Salmon. Sanchez will get the corner here for Houston.
They've conceded goals at set pieces, Gotham, in the last few weeks. One of them, an own goal. They were clearing off the line from a corner and it hit Mandy Freeman in the back. So they'll be looking to be a little bit better organized this time around.
Sanchez so dangerous on these as well. It's up. Bounce around from Ogle. And now a reset. Eddie. Another service into Schmidt. Floats over and out. It will be Beto's ball.
Just thought Ogle could have maybe hit that a bit harder when it came to it. She tried to side foot it, man. Perhaps a volley. Especially with so many bodies in front, you get a deflection. Goalkeeper can't see through all the legs, but opportunity lost for the dash.
Schmidt. Tackled away by Mewis. Here comes Purse. Smith to her right. That's where she goes. Taylor Smith in the box. Cross is deflected.
You can see they are a threat though with Taylor Smith's pace and Midge Purse's pace down either flank. It's difficult for Houston Dash. Can't give them too much space because they'll get punished.
Andy Freeman, off to Purse. Schmidt, Salmon. 21 years old, Ebony Salmon. Shea Groom, 4 assists on the year for Houston. Ever since they acquired Salmon, it's really opened up Groom as well. And we're starting to see what she's capable of as a distributor.
I think so many defenders are so worried about Ebony Salmon, they're watching her and not watching everybody else. Much credit to the coach, Juan Carlos Amaros, from the moment he came in.
Prince, easy pickup for Beto's.
So from the moment he came in, that was the match against Chicago Red Stars when they had this quick counter-attacks and just knocking the ball to Ebony Salmon, and she left the centre-backs of Chicago for dead so many times. I think defenders now are very wise to that, and they're staying a yard or two behind Ebony Salmon, so she can't beat them for pace. What it does, though, is you notice it opens up space for other strikers for the dash to shine and get some free area to work in.
Well, no other coach in NWSL history has won their first 3 games. And Amaros did it with ease at times. Again, 2 decisive victories over Chicago and Gotham, part of that run. And then a 2-1 win at Lumen Field against OL Reign. That was the one that proved it wasn't fluky, yep. Because winning in Seattle is extremely difficult. They're the only team to do that this year.
Absolutely, and their expected goals were higher. So it wasn't like it was a lucky win. They deserve to beat OL Reign. Very impressive what Juan Carlos Amaros has done already. And the question is, can he keep it going? And if they win today, they go joint top alongside Port and Thorns.
Anumanu offside. Well, for Houston, their schedule gets really difficult. It's always difficult in the NWSL, but it's going to get really difficult. And, I mean, even on Saturday, they play San Diego, another team fighting to get that first spot. So it's actually a really tough schedule here for Houston just this week. I mean, having played Friday, now Wednesday, and then they'll have to play again on Saturday. And then they play Washington twice, Chicago, OL Reign, and Angel City to end the season. So, you know, again, nothing is a given in the NWSL, but those are a lot of teams fighting for the playoff picture. And Washington, while seems like they are out, with all the talent Washington has, they're going to give teams fits at the end of the year. They're a team that could ruin someone's playoff chances.
Oh, every chance.
Yeah.
And this is an amazing league, NWSL, because it's so tight. You can look at teams at the bottom, such as Courage and Washington, even Gotham. And, you know, in a different sort of situation this year, maybe different injuries. They could be near the top. They're good enough. It's just getting the good run. It's getting confidence going. It's not having players who are ill, etc. And this season has been a tough one for Gotham. So many players out for various reasons, and it's impacted their form.
Eddie surveys. Now Sanchez, two defenders on, splits, and Peirce gets called for the foul. We're going to get a card against Midge Peirce. That's the first yellow card we've seen today.
To see that again, just to see how much there was there, because Eddie's had a few pushes and shoves and not got a yellow card. Was it a professional foul? Did she just pull it back there? Didn't see a lot. It almost looked like Maria Sanchez sort of ran into her a little bit. Maybe we couldn't see a tug from our angle. But given that Elizabeth Eddy's been warned twice for similar grievances, then tough on Midge Peirce.
Now Sanchez and Ogle will set up on the free kick. You see Smith and Peirce in front for Gotham. Hesitation, now it's Sanchez. Nice curl to it. That lands in front of Zerboni. Prince tries to pick up, skying through. Now Salmon deflects off a couple of bodies. Rolls out. Johnson just boxes out Schmidt. But it should be a corner for Houston.
I think Bezos was saying clear the ball away, and it didn't get cleared. And so they've given away a cheap corner. Ebony Salmon trying the shot and takes the deflection. That's what I was saying earlier. It's worth taking a shot when you've got that many bodies in front of you, because the deflection can take it past the goalkeeper. It was a difficult thing here. The goalkeeper will tend to push the player away if the player steps on them, but at the same time, if they step on them, it can be seen as obstruction. So the referee just, I think, saying to Michelle Bados, don't you push. If she steps back into you, I will blow up for obstruction.
From Sanchez, Bados through the air. It's like Anamanu fell on the ground there. Appears to be all right.
Bados, another good clean catch. The goalkeeper's had a solid game so far, 34 years of age. Michelle Bados, lots of experience. And they're going to need that. If she can help them keep clean sheets, if you can keep it tight at the back, then Gotham, with their front three, will always have a chance.
Beautiful feed from Smith to Anumanu. Has a chance, bounces through, and it's saved by Eddie. Wow, should have been a Gotham goal, but Elizabeth Eddie denies.
Actually, the save also from Jane Campbell. It slowed the ball right down, allowing Eddie to come and kick it off the line there. We're just talking about how good the front three are. Well, the timing of that one, perfect. On Amanu goes through, opens it up, tries to sort of sneak it underneath the goalkeeper. And Jane Campbell gets a good solid touch on that with her right arm, as you say, Elizabeth Eddy, then clearing the danger.
Well, not out of the woods yet. Here comes Gotham again. Mewis. And that touch from Johnson is wide. Well, nothing there on the corner. But the attack has been pretty solid for Gotham.
They've looked really good compared to their last match anyway against Owell Rain. Looks solid in defense. Goalkeepers come for some good crosses. They've tested Jane Campbell a few times, which is more than what happened in her last match against Racing Louisville. So she'll be enjoying the bit of action she has been getting there, Jane Campbell. I do wonder though for Houston, and you would know this for our international viewers, but the travel they've done to get to Seattle, I guess that's what, 5 hours across the country of travel, then down to Houston, another probably 5 hours. It's like crisscrossing Europe from England to Russia and down to Spain and back. It's a lot of travel.
It's a ton of travel. Plus, they go home technically on Saturday, Gotham does, but they're actually playing in Philadelphia, so they're not in New Jersey.
Wow, so more travel for Gotham. Living out of suitcases at the moment. And I guess that's also made it difficult for new coach Hugh Menzies. When he chatted to us a couple of days ago, he said, we haven't had time to train. I'm just getting to know the players, getting to chat to them and make sure they understand and appreciate my philosophy and we're all on the same page. He said, but in terms of training with them and being able to do anything, nothing. Just watch a few videos, talk it through, and hopefully they will understand what he wants to try and implement.
Mewis leaves it for Dorsey. Prince is there. Groom. Salmon in the middle. From Shea Groom. all the way up and hits the top of the netting.
It's a poor cross there from Shea Groom. Such a good player. She can do better than that, and I think she holds her hand up to acknowledge that. She had options in the box, near post and far post. And in the end, the ball just knocked harmlessly over the crossbar. Such a good player in the air as well, Shea Groom. Very useful at set pieces. Managed to create some problems. Scored one goal and I think forced an own goal as well. And she does it by just getting up in the air and challenging so well.
One thing to note about Shea Groom is that she has to be careful in this match because she has 4 yellow cards over the course of the season. If she gets another, she'll have to sit in the next match, which again is against San Diego. So they can't afford that. Michelle Batos. See, Menzies got to be happy with his performance so far.
Very, very happy. We were saying it's a 6 to 8 week job. He's here and just until the end of the season. Try and turn things around. He said to us, using his words, he said, if we make the playoff, that's gravy. In other words, he doesn't expect to get it. He just wants to see an improvement. And I think we've seen that already in these 30 minutes. He's got to be very happy. But it's a 90-minute game, well, 90-plus. And as much as he's happy with this 30 minutes, he wants to build on it. See if they can get that breakthrough. And they've come close a few times on Amanu through one-on-one. Taylor Smith had that lovely cross that Mitch Purse nearly got on the end of. So they've certainly threatened Houston Dash.
Well, we are in the hydration break here in the first half. Of course, Houston, Texas in the summer, that is absolutely necessary. But as we take a look at some of the stats, I mean, XG is not particularly high for either side, but there's been kind of one strong look for each team. Both teams actually have 2 shots on target, and XG is just 0.2 pretty much for both sides.
I think the quality of Gotham's chances are better. Onamonu is through one-on-one. Good save from Jane Campbell in picture there. And Taylor Smith was literally inches away from giving Mitch Purse a tap in at the far post. Whereas Houston Dash, it's been shots from the edge of the box, deflections, balls bobbling. It just hasn't been as clear cut. And again, no doubt that Hugh Menzies is very excited by the front three of Taylor Smith, Mitch Purse, and Effie Onamanu.
Well, this is a Houston team that can certainly turn it up a notch, and it feels like they might have to get Ebony Salmon a little bit more involved than she has been so far. Again, Salmon has been the hottest NWSL player since July 17th, in which she scored 6 goals, again, in just a month. 6 goals for Salmon. Deanna Ordonez is kind of right behind her with North Carolina with 5 goals. So those are a pair of extremely young players that are, it seems, the future of the NWSL. So that's been a fun race to watch.
That's the other side of the coin there, from the young players to Zaboni, who's been a top-class professional, 35 years of age now, and still fit, still strong, still leading the team. Wonderful, wonderful player, wonderful example to the young pros coming through the game.
Well, besides minutes and, you know, game started where she's in the top 2 in the NWSL, she actually leads the NWSL in fouls by a lot. 100 more than the person next to her. So
well, she's a tough player.
Yeah,
huh?
Extremely physical player. Yeah. Wearing that captain's armband as per usual. Captain for Houston today is Jane Campbell.
Temperature-wise, we assuming it's run in the late 90s, mid-90s perhaps, which in Celsius is around about 30 degrees Celsius, so very, very warm evening.
And always humid in Houston as well. Schmidt, denied by Freeman, tries it again, this time off to Sanchez. Collects. Jean shading her, Sanchez looking to make a move. Purse trying to help out, pushed all the way back to the corner, then broken up.
Good feet skills there from Maria Sanchez. Wonderful touches, but in the end, doesn't get her very far. Ellie Jean standing strong.
Saw that block from Mandy Freeman. Prince wide.
Just wondering for a moment there whether Jennifer Cujo missed the ball and got the player, but there was no appeals for a penalty. It doesn't seem like there was a problem. You could be very careful in the box when you swing a foot in case the player, the attacking player, just gets the ball before you and then you're liable to be blown up for a penalty.
Well, if you're Gotham, you want no more of that. They've given up 4 PKs this year, and all 4 have gone in for opponents. They have not taken a PK themselves, weirdly enough. They're the only NWSL team with that stat. Prince, aggressive, trying to get it back here for Houston. Against scoreless, PNC Stadium in Houston, Texas. We don't have a goal yet between Houston, Gotham FC. Elizabeth Eddy. Jean is out. Sanchez. Quick pass to Schmidt, little give and go. Here's Sanchez, tries to touch back, and it's read well by Zerboni. Eddy powers through. Sanchez puts a cross up, and it's headed way high from Groom.
There's that danger of Groom with a header again. So, so good in the air, and that ball whipped in. Mitch Purse had the opportunity to clear it and try to be clever and lost possession. Have a look. Firstly, Mitch Purse doesn't go with the runner. Comes back to Mitch Purse. She's got the ball. She tries a little clever nutmeg or something. It doesn't come off. And from that ball gets whipped in at near post. And Shay Groom, so good in the air. Gets up brilliantly, but just can't direct the header.
Again, Sanchez just often hailed as an unsung hero for this Houston side. Missed some time on international duty with Mexico. Of course, Mexico competed in CONCACAF play and did not have a good run. But since she's returned, it's been fun to watch her groom and salmon work. Beitos. Schmidt, Zerboni. Seasoned vets fighting for it, and Zerboni wins out.
Okay, I'm not so sure about that. I thought Sophie Schmidt just got to the ball slightly earlier, but Zerboni, such a clever professional player, and convinces the referee that that's a foul. Hugh Menzies up off the bench, having his say.
Marcel Johnson will take this for Gotham. Mewis, back turned, Zerboni. Cujo. Salmon with some pressure. Beitos, another player that was in the league in 2013 when the NWSL started. Just missed one season. So 9 years in the NWSL for Beitos.
Pressure here, turnover ball.
Prince to Salmon, floats by her. Jean heads it out. Schmidt's right there. Ogle now waits for it. Sanchez has it swiped. Purse has some momentum here for Gotham. Jacobs with the touch for Houston. Back off. Dorsey. Anumanu offside again, second time.
It's difficult for Anumanu because she can't see what's going on behind her. She's not looking down the line of the defenders, and so it's easy for her to stray into an offside position. But she is that constant threat down that left-hand side. Well, I'm not so sure she is offside when that is played. But unfortunately, the assistant ref doesn't get the advantage of seeing that like we do in slow motion.
Well, a race to get it here. Sanchez edging out. Knocks down Jean. Almost saves it from going out of play. Now Sanchez slow to get up.
They really do work hard, Houston Dash, at that press, at making it difficult for teams to play out and winning high balls and chasing it down as Sanchez does here. And we've seen some turnover ball for them. In fact, if I go back to the Chicago game, which was Juan Carlos Amorós' first game in charge, their opening goal came from closing down on the edge of the box, a six-yard box, and getting turnover ball.
Anamanu onside this time. Not in with a beautiful cutoff. And it hops to Campbell.
Good little half chance here for Anamanu. And she tries to cut back in. I don't want to be too critical, but could she have kept it on her left foot and kept running? Instead, she cuts back in and runs into the defender and loses the ball. Once again, Gotham up front, having a few moments where, just with a little bit of luck, could be so different. They could score, come close.
Salmon muscles her way through. No numbers, but Ebony Salmon takes a shot, and it's just a bouncer off to Beitos.
No problem for the goalkeeper, body behind the ball, easy catch. For me, Salmon's real threat is when she's played, given the ball through, and she can run onto it and give her, you know, show her pace.
Yeah, few players in the league faster than Ebony Salmon. Houston ball. Again, PNC Stadium here as we head towards the end of the first half. Gotham and Houston. Dash searching for win number 8 on the season. And for Gotham, look, they only have 4 wins, but interestingly enough, they've done the bulk of their damage away from Harrison. So they have 3 wins of 4 on the road. Groom. Salmon. Corner coming.
Ebony Salmon causing some problems and wins a corner. Just still don't think that's where her strength is. Needs to be in that box on the shoulder of the center back and just turn and use that blistering pace. Nonetheless, when it comes to Maria Sanchez putting the ball in, they're always a threat, Houston Dash.
See Ogle right in front of Beitos. Not in Groom. Salmon hanging out in the area. Off to Groom, and we got a whistle.
Straight away. As soon as she blocked the goalkeeper, referee was waiting. You don't have to actually physically stand in the goalkeeper's way. What she's saying is you can't stand there and roadblock the goalkeeper, which is what she did. She'll say, well, I was just standing there. I didn't need to move, but you clearly are blocking the goalkeeper's path.
Well, that had to be your biggest pet peeve, I would imagine.
Yes, well, you can hear it in my voice when I talk about it. But as a goalkeeper, you have forever been blocked, pushed, kicked, punched, you name it, to try and stop you from getting to the ball. And sometimes referees see it, but sometimes they don't. And it's very frustrating if they score from something where you feel that you've been fouled. But that's all part of the game. These days with VAR, though, it isn't VAR in this NWSL, but in other leagues as far, and when there is, then generally the goalkeeper is protected.
Should be coming future years VAR for the NWSL.
Well, it's just this league is getting better and better every year and making changes and investing money, so absolutely there will be VAR, there'll be goal line technology, I believe.
See this again, off for Purse, and Naughton just gets her foot on that in time. Otherwise, Purse has a straight shot to goal. Ogle bounces it off of Zerboni. Eddie, Sanchez, Schmidt. Anumanu comes back, earns possession. Cujo. For Smith. Campbell whiffs. Jacobs is there to clean up. Boy, that could have been a disaster.
I don't know what Jane Campbell's doing there. It's not her ball. It doesn't need to be there. The center back's got it all dealt with. You come out and all you do is cause confusion. And on top of that, you miss the kick anyway.
Smith. Jacobs taps it out. Taylor Smith for Gotham will get the throw in. Let's see this again.
And look, it's being dealt with by your defender. You don't need to get involved. Maybe she was just getting bored at the back and wanted to wanted to play a little bit.
She was trying out for the new field position role, that's what I think. Jean. Mandy Freeman. Salmon on her back. Turns and uses Beitos.
Coming up for a match and a half without Houston Dash scoring after all the goals they did score, including the four away at Gotham. They just haven't been able to get their attack going in the last match against Racing Louisville, and this one haven't been able to get good ball to Ebony Salmon so she can use her pace, haven't been able to get the crosses in that much. Maria Sanchez just with a one that Shea Groom tried to head on target and couldn't. Sophia Schmidt, nothing from her, no golassos from 30 yards. So it's been a bit of a dull Houston Dash attack for this half and the previous match against Racing Louisville.
And we'll see if there's adjustments that need to be made, or maybe at this point there's enough tape on some of the, you know, the Salmon collaboration with the rest of these players that teams are starting to figure it out a little bit better. We are in stoppage time here in the first half from Sanchez. Anumanu last to touch Mewis. Anumanu goes down in the box and Mewis is able to clear. Jacobs right back at it. Smith watches it bounce out. It should be Gotham ball. Goal kick coming. 3 minutes of stoppage time.
Pity that ball in. It's overhit by Jacobs and you want to try and just drop it right in the middle and give your strikers something to go for.
Well, every coach when they come in, you know, to take on a new role makes a change or two, and we've definitely seen Emeros play Natalie Jacobs more than she was playing before. Jacobs, of course, was with Emeros at Real Betis, so it makes a lot of sense. They have the history, and for a coach that's walking into a completely new situation, it's probably good to have some familiar faces.
Absolutely, and to have some eyes and ears in the locker room just to get some feedback as to what's going on. But for Juan Carlos Amorosi, he's got the likes of Michelle Alozi on the bench, Michaela Abams. He does have options. If somehow they're managing to mark Ebony Salmon too easily, then he might feel that he's got some options he can try instead.
But Alozi had a strong match against Racing Louisville when entered in off the bench. Ogle. Sanchez. Jean. Keeps it away.
Seems to be a bit of a waste of a free kick playing it down the line there instead of just dropping it into the box and having, you know, allowing Shea Groom to have a go at flicking it on. It all comes to nothing. Ellie Jean doing a good job of seeing that ball over the line.
From Eddie Schmidt, one final push here for Houston. Salmon. Mandy Freeman, again, has been tasked with dealing with Salmon a lot, and so far, so good for Freeman.
Good defensively as well for Gotham. If they concede the way they do against OL Rain, doesn't matter how good your attack is, you're always out of the game when you're conceding four. But keeping a clean sheet, you always fancy that Onomanu and Mitch Purse in particular, and maybe even Taylor Smith will find their way to the back of the net at some stage in this match.
Schmidt, Groom, Jacobs comes up, puts it in the area. Salmon tries a one time. Jacobs in that corner. Dorsey with the push out, and there's the whistle to end the half. So again, we've played one half of action and we don't have a score between Houston and Gotham. And Gary, for Gotham, this is so much better. And for Houston, they need to find the back of the net.
Absolutely. It's two different stories. For Houston Dash, it's just frustrating now. You know, 1.5 games without scoring. They just haven't been able to get their front players into this match much. For Gotham, clean sheet, much better organized, sharp up front with the front three. So one coach, Hugh Menzies, is going in very pumped up. That's the Gotham coach. For Juan Carlos Amorosi, he's got to find a way of getting his team to play a lot better in the second half.
Well, again, Dash and Gotham scoreless at the halftime break. We'll see if things change when we get back for it the second half. Again, we return after this break here on the International Feed.
So I can go with this.
Welcome back as we get set to start the second half. Gotham and Houston scoreless after 45 minutes of play. Alongside Gary Bailey, I'm Morris Sheridan. And look, on paper, there's been 3 shots on target for Houston, 2 for Gotham. But it does feel like Gotham's had better opportunities than Houston thus far.
It certainly does. They've had sharper opportunities. Onamanu threw one-on-one and fancied her groove. Perhaps score. Jane Campbell coming up with a good save. But I do feel the owners very much on Houston Dash. They are the home side. They need to find a way to break down Gotham and expect to see a few changes in the second half. They do have a choice of substitutes, and Ryan Guerra has dropped to the bench. I thought she was very impressive in previous games with her pace. We've got Michaela Aban, Michelle Alozi, Marissa Vigiani. There's 4 players that Juan Carlos Amoros can turn to if he doesn't start to get his progress. And I think there's one change there already.
Yeah, so it looks like Ryan Garris and Vigiano will come in to start this second half. So Vigiano in the midfield and Garris at that left back spot. Presumably taking off Eddie and taking off Oval.
That's nice, brave decision making by Juan Carlos Amoros, the Dash interim coach. He's obviously decided that the first half they just weren't good enough going forward, the home side, and he's made the changes.
Ogle tracking backwards. Does look like she has moved back to center back. And do my eyes deceive me? Prysock is... No, Prysock is there. Never mind. Oh, we see Elizabeth Eddy on the bench again. Entered into the starting lineup and it gets subbed out at halftime. And that is where Garris will sit, at left back. Well, this is a Houston team whose unbeaten streak is at risk as we see Shea Groom was removed. Vigiano is going to come in for Shea Groom. Had a good chance out of the air.
Interesting. I wonder if Shea Groom picked up a bit of a strain or some other reason, because she scored a wonderful header when these two teams met a few games ago. Fantastic ball in from Maria Sanchez, and Shea Groom getting up and smashing her header into the corner of the net. She's always so dangerous at set pieces, so taking off an important piece off the board as far as Houston Dash are concerned.
Vigiano, Garris. Purse reaches for it. Ebony Salmon, here she comes. You see Prince an option as well. Salmon cuts through, maybe doesn't need it. Freeman breaks it up. Out for Gotham. Mewis for Gotham. Campbell shuffles back. Mewis takes a shot and Naughton blocks it away.
By the way, talking about Mewis, we haven't discussed the fact that she was a Houston player for a long time, 2017 up until 2022. 63 appearances, 12 goals for Mewis. So must be an unusual feeling to come and play against your former team.
Well, Ebony Salmon did it against Racing Louisville on the Houston side in the last match.
And that was very recent, because she just left Racing Louisville.
This year, yes.
And she just scored 6 goals in 4 games since leaving Racing Louisville, so I'm sure they were thinking maybe we should have kept her.
Yeah, the salmon experiment has certainly paid off for Houston. That is evident. As we see Prysock with the foul.
Each person, wonderful, wonderful player, and beginning to show her ability for the women's national team in the recent tournaments. Ability to score goals, run at defenders. That's why it's such a shock to so many Gotham fans that they're sitting near the bottom of the table, given the quality they have in the likes of Mitch Purse and Christy Mewis and Paul Zerboni.
Dorsey, Prince, head-to-head. Schmidt. Cujo commits a foul.
There's a bunch of players missing for Gotham. You mentioned them earlier. Ashlyn Harris, Ali Krieger, Kawasumi, Ali Long on maternity leave, Domi Richardson. You know, these really fantastic players amongst that group.
Capri Stidasco as well.
Yes, yes, good point.
It's just been a strange year for Gotham. They've lost 7 of their last 8 matches. And at this point, it's just, again, one match at a time, trying to get back on track and finish the season on a high note. So again, you see Garris has been utilized here and there in that left back role. And I think, as you mentioned, Gary, the option with her is that she will just, you know, streak up that left side and provide potentially service in a salmon that they haven't had yet.
Well, she actually provided a salmon with an assist against Chicago right. Red Stars, doing exactly what you said, bombing up the left-hand side, great pace, and then Ebony Salmon peeled off and she just played the ball through for her. So that is what they will want to see, certainly what Juan Carlos Amoros will want to see from Ryan Garris. Of course, if she pushes up and leaves a gap, then you wonder whether Mitch Purse can take advantage of that space. So a little bit of a chess game in terms of who benefits from what. But as a home side, I do think Juan Carlos Amoros has to be on the front foot. And that's what he's trying to do.
Well, if you're Gotham, though, you're living in a comfortable spot. This is not a team that scores a ton of goals, so you would like to keep it low scoring, and that's where it's been so far. Obviously, we haven't seen a score quite yet, but Gotham has been shut out 7 times this year, and they only have 10 goals on the season. So if you can live, you know, they're not a team that's going to score multiple goals often, so, you know, one goal game is definitely to their advantage. Mewis on a free kick. You can see Zerboni is offside. Now moves on. Adumanu. Over the head of Smith.
Adumanu doing well to get to the ball. Just nobody behind her that could pick up the flick on. Decent ball in from Mewis as well. Have a look. Right into the danger area. And just maybe she gets too much on it. Yeah, Taylor Smith at the back there. Just you can see by the hand movement that she was just a bit disappointed that the flick on had too much pace and too much height, and she couldn't reach it.
Zerboni. Mewis, Adumanu, aggressive in front of Campbell. The slide off to Jacobs just in time.
That was close from Jane Campbell. Brilliant timing, but if you get that wrong, it's going to be very embarrassing.
Well, it's the second time we've seen a close call. The first time in the first half came way off the goal line, whiffed, and then it nearly ended up in a score for Gotham. Beitos very strong.
Sorry, I was going to say, Beitos must be very happy with the way things are going. He conceded 4 in the last match. And to keep a clean sheet, do as well as she's done with every cross that's been knocked in. That's what a goalkeeper wants. And in front of her, I think Estelle Johnson, Mandy Freeman in particular, has played very well. They've been solid. Ellie Jean at right back. Top class so far.
Yeah, again, Megan Rapinoe just terrorized this Gotham team on Sunday. She did have a foot or a throw in every single goal. She actually threw it in all the way in the box, and Rose Lavelle scored off of it. It was a just complete defensive lapse for Gotham. everything just looks a lot stronger for Gotham today. Again, on the road in Houston, never an easy place to play. Putting up a fight here against a team in Houston that's second in the NWSL standings as Prysock makes a move past Smith, runs into Zerboni.
You're talking about that match against Owell Rain. There were really four individual errors for the four goals. You mentioned the one from the throw, and I think it was Estelle Johnson wasn't marking tight, but Ellie Jean gave away a penalty. Beitos mishandled the Rapino shot. It was an own goal by Freeman as she went for a header and deflected a pass to a goalkeeper. And coach Hugh Menzies says, look, when you have individual errors, you can sort it out. You can, you know, you can sort of try and avoid making personal errors in the next game. He said that he's not worried about. Just feels that tactically they've been too defensive.
Hurst is offside. That's the third time a Gotham player has been offside today. Twice to Anamanu. Cujo. Hurst.
Just noticing Ebony Salmon getting pushed off the ball way too easily by Mandy Freeman in that previous attack, and just wondering if they might change her eventually, Ebony Salmon, because she's not getting the sort of ball she needs to perform, which is to show her pace. She's not a big target, number nine. She's not going to hold the ball up, and I think a BAM might be a better option for Hugh Menzies.
Purse takes off past Jacobs. Purse plays through contact, the cross to Smith, and it hits the back of her forehead. Now Taylor Smith has another opportunity, trying to get past Garris, and Garris clears.
Mitch Purse again, brilliant down that left hand side, pace, power, puts the ball into the box, and Taylor Smith just unable to get on the end of it.
Well, again, because we haven't seen them paired up too much, we didn't really know what their chemistry or connection was going to look like, and so far it's been pretty strong for Gotham. And it's too bad it's happening so late in the season, because I think if we had more games to play, it could really grow.
Absolutely. Here is Mitch Purse with the power and strength, puts the ball in, does so well here, puts it in. Taylor Smith is just literally half a foot too high for it. It's a bit lower, she can head it down and maybe get a shot on target. But again, Gotham up front do look dangerous at times.
Well, here comes Prince, blazing through. Nichelle Prince puts on a cross, nobody home. Salmon was back behind. Now Sanchez, right back in. Schmidt misses. Prince has an opportunity, tangled up. And Nichelle Prince, believe that, knocked into her hand.
Yeah, it did look like a handball, but good pressure from Houston Dash. A little bit better. They really haven't created anything specific in this match, and which is why the XG is so low. This a decent ball in, but enough white shirts to deal with it. Comes back in, gets recycled into the box. Maybe she's coming from an offside position. That's what it was. She was coming from an offside position there. And Nichelle Prince, a little bit better from the home side though.
Well, for all the Ebony Salmon talk, Prince is certainly an explosive player as well, who we haven't seen too much of in this match so far. Then five goals for Nichelle Prince. There's another offside for Gotham, make that four.
Can't quite believe it, Purse. Neither can I. She's looking down the line. She can see all the defenders. You should never get caught offside there. And she's going to get a yellow card for not being 10 yards away. I thought Purse was already on the yellow. Yes.
That's a red card for Midge Purse. And you can see the reaction from Anamanu and the rest of this Gotham team, because Purse is going to have to sit for the rest of this game, and now Gotham down to 10 players.
Well, referee's saying you've got to get 10 yards away. Mitch Purse is maybe saying, well, I didn't have a chance to get 10 yards away. I'd like to see it again.
And now Zerboni's going to get a yellow card.
That's a very soft red, Mitch Purse. I felt the first one was a bit harsh as well. And Hugh Menzies is asking the question. Yeah, she's trying to block it. You've got to get 10 yards away. So that one is on Midge Purse. And you've got also, when you are on a yellow, you can't give the referee the excuse, not excuse, but you can't give the referee a reason to give you a second yellow. And she's given her the reason. They've lost one of their best players now, Gotham.
for today and the next match too. And Gotham, this is a team that, again, can't really afford to have certain players miss games. And so Purse is out, and now Houston finds themselves in a very similar spot of their last match against Satara Murray, got a double yellow for Racing Louisville, and Houston played up a player for the entire second half and still did not win that game. So we'll see if, as history repeats itself, things change for the Dash.
Tough one for Hugh Menzies. He's got enough problems on his hands already, having been beaten 4-1, coming in as an interim coach. They're on the road, they're traveling, they're probably tired from all the travel, and they just were looking good in this match, and now they're down to 10 players. So big challenge now for Gotham. If they can at least disappear from this ground with a point from this match, I think they've done really, really well. But hard work ahead now for the visiting side.
Prince. Intercepted by Dorsey. Cujo. Can't play with it. Schmidt behind Christy Mewis. Leaves it up for Smith. Campbell off her line. Another kick out.
And Campbell coming when she doesn't need to. Her defenders had that under control. She gets away with it this time.
Beautiful service from Garris, and it's just a little bit ahead of Ebony Salmon. Beto's there to clean it up.
See that? Now that's better for me for Ebony Salmon, because what you're doing there is you're relying on her pace. You're putting ball over the top and saying, come on, you're quick. See if you can get on the end of that. Now she didn't that time, Ebony Salmon, but she might do the next time. That's the sort of service I think she's been waiting for.
So it does look like in the aftermath of that Purse double yellow, Anamanu also got a yellow card just for arguing. One thing to note that this has happened multiple times during the NWSL season, you know, where a team has been a player up, and yet none of those teams have won the game. Whether it was Dahlkemper going down for San Diego, or Lucy for Angel City, Rapino, and then of course Satara Murray, none of those teams were able to pull out a victory.
It is amazing. You do try a little bit harder when you're down a player. But they've got opportunity now, Houston Dash. They're at home. They've got a chance to stretch it. They know what they didn't do in the last match, and no doubt they would have looked at the film and gone, okay, if this ever happens again, this is what we need to do, which is basically stretch. Often you switch play, which they're doing right now. You go left and right and back again. You stretch the defense as much as you can.
Well, Jacob's trying to do that. Off to Ogle. Garris Mewis reads that time, off her back. Garris at it again, the rookie for Houston.
Sitting very deep now, Gotham, aren't they? They're in their final third, all the players just denying space, but when you sit deep, you bring the opposition onto you. That's always the problem.
Well, knowing down a player, knowing they are down a player, Gotham is going to make a change. So Anamanu will come out. Again, was also on a yellow, and Paige Monahan will enter the game.
She's been coming off illness as well, Anamanu. So it's understandable. Such a pity, because I love watching her play. Such a great player in terms of her ability to read the game, Ife Anamanu. But they have brought fresh legs on. They're going to need them. They're going to need Paige Monahan to do a lot of work in this remaining period of time.
Well, we just took a look at the two yellow cards that Midge Purse received. So again, she is not only out of this game, she will miss the next match against Orlando. And that's on Saturday, so it's not too far away. And they're playing that game in Philadelphia, where the MLS side, the Philadelphia Union, play at Subaru Park. So no Midge Purse.
And to be fair, Midge Purse on a yellow, you can't be trying to block a free kick less than 10 yards away. You know you're going to get into trouble for that. If you're not on a yellow, fine, if you really feel you need to do it. But even then, I can't see the point. When you're on a yellow, you have to have game management all the time.
Garris for Prince. Up in the air, now back for Zavoni. And head-to-head contact, the training staff will come out. Looks like Dorsey.
Ball in. She gets up there.
Do you want me just to confirm with them?
Not quite sure whether there was head contact or was the elbow that hit her, but either way, it was painful. Good to see Imani Dorsey's back up on her feet.
Gives both Houston and Gotham a chance to reset, talk things over, and if you're the Dash, how you will approach trying to pick up 3 points here, because you have the advantage, a player up. Again, a four-game unbeaten streak on the line for the Dash. And obviously, you're at home, too. Be nice to pick up three before you go to San Diego on Saturday.
Yeah, they've got the heat on their side as well. The Dash players are a lot more used to the humidity and heat than the Gotham players are. You've got to use that to your advantage. Ryan Garris there for me. She can make things happen because she's coming on with fresh legs and she's very, very quick. So on that left-hand side, expect to see a lot more of Ryan Garris.
Well, early, she's had some pretty good services intended for Ebony Salmon. At least trying it a little bit more than in the first half. And we'll see how Houston responds.
It's a tough one losing Mitch Purser. I mean, she's the top goal scorer for the team. She's tied in top assists. She's got the top shots, 28. And she's tied on shots on goal with 7 at the top. So she is pretty much the number one player for Gotham. And now she's off the pitch. And that means Zaboni, Christy Mewis, and others are going to have to raise their game even higher if they want to leave the PNC Stadium with a point or more.
Well, one time this year, a team that was down to 10 players actually won the game. That was Angel City. They were able to come back against San Diego, and the second Tyler Lucy came off, and they were down to 10 players. They went down and scored. So never say never. It's just an uphill battle for Gotham. But this is a team that, compared to Houston, kind of has, I'll say it this way, they have a lot less to lose, Gotham. And so they're trying to pick up 3 points. They can't really play it safe at this point in the season. And so, you know, it's worth the risk to be a little bit more aggressive here than you probably normally would be down a player. We'll see how Menzies approaches this. It hasn't been an easy run for him. Right away you go to Seattle, then after you have to come to Houston, and now you lose Midge Purse in the second half.
Yep, it's a difficult situation for Hugh Menzies, but like he said to us, it's a 6 to 8 week project as far as he's concerned. It's just about lifting the club away from the bottom, getting some positive momentum going into the end of the year. And if they did make the playoffs, which is extremely difficult, that would be a massive bonus. But I don't think realistically the owners or Hugh Menzies expects that to happen. He just wants to see a better performance. And to be fair, two-thirds of the way, just past the two-thirds mark, they've been really good, Gotham. They've played everything really well. They've been tight in defense. They've been creative and dangerous in attack. The only problem they've had is, unfortunately, Mitch Purse getting that second yellow. Unnecessarily so.
I will say one stat for Gotham is this is about the time where they start to give up the bulk of their goals. In fact, 14 of their goals have been conceded after the 60th minute this year. So we'll see if that continues. Again, Houston coming off a draw, scoreless draw against Racing Louisville. They're just hoping this doesn't start a slide where they're, you know, where they're lacking offensive opportunities. And so it is important for them to find the back of the net here in this one, because the last thing you want is to, you know, be shut out in two straight games.
Absolutely. Important for both sides for different reasons. And the Dash are at home as well. So in front of your own crowd, you really want to put on a performance. And for Hugh Menzies, just turning things around. If he can leave here being down to 10 men with the performance we've seen, if he leaves with a 0-0 draw, I think the coach will be extremely happy.
One thing for Gotham is they haven't played to a draw this year.
Well, maybe today's the day.
4-9, no draws. They're the only NWSL team.
That's amazing throughout a season, not getting a single draw.
Again, you see Monahan replace Anumanu. Fresh legs for Gotham. Certainly will need it down the stretch. Smith. Freeman. Puts it up for Mewis. Campbell all the way out. Garris back and forth with Smith, and Houston will get the throw in here.
Well, I guess at the end of the day, a draw wouldn't be the end of the world for Houston Dash. I mean, they continue unbeaten for 5 games, 3 wins, 2 draws. They're second spot. They're yet only two points behind the leaders, Portland Thorns. So in that sense, it's not the end of the world for the Dash. It's just you're at home, you're against 10 men, as you quite rightly said, for the second game running. It would just be a real downer for them, even though overall their position in the league table looks so good.
Schmidt, Prince, this is danger for Houston. Nichelle Prince takes a shot, and again, it just bounces to Beatos, who hasn't been challenged too much in this match so far.
Doesn't catch it, does she, Prince? Doesn't get much power behind it, no threat whatsoever to Michelle Beatos. From a situation where Ebony Salmon couldn't stop scoring to now where the front three are just battling, poor old Juan Carlos Amaros must be just wondering how things can change so quickly to his strikers.
Monahan on the wing, on the attack now for Gotham. Smith centers, rips a shot, and it sails one hop and into the crowd.
Took a small deflection on the way, and she's saying to the rest of the team, come on, let's raise the energy, 20 minutes to go. And that's good leadership there from Taylor Smith, 28 years of age, just trying to make sure everyone around her feels the energy, feels the need to keep working really hard right until that final whistle.
Mewis will take the corner. You see Ellie Jean as a short option. Monahan right in the center. Mewis. Zerboni can't get above Katie Naughton. Smith. Dorsey. Dorsey at it again. Jean. Off Katie Naughton. Here's a chance for Estelle Johnson, and Jane Campbell just barely beats her there.
Estelle Johnson, lovely little bit of skill there, just to flick that over her shoulder, and goalkeeper reads it extremely well. But sustained pressure here from Gotham. It just kept winning all these balls. That lovely little flick over. And goalkeeper quick to see the danger and beat Estelle Johnson to the ball. A nice bit of pressure there from Gotham.
Sanchez. Prince keeps it in, off her heel, just kidding. All right, so we will see a sub for Gotham. Cujo comes out and Taryn Torres will come in.
Cujo has done well playing in that lone six role, defensive midfielder. Doing a really good job.
Looks like we'll also see Jenna Bike replace Amani Dorsey. So two subs for Gotham again as they trek towards the end of this match, down a player.
And these fresh legs will be so important because you're down a player, they've got to do some extra work. And not just the running, it's the sort of enthusiasm they bring on the pitch, spreading the word and trying to get everyone around them who is now pretty tired, getting them to just push right until the end.
Well, Jenna Bike is a national team replacement player that Gotham ended up signing for the remainder of this season. You see Bike right there, again coming in for Dorsey. Earned her keep in that stint when the likes of Mewis, Purse, Anumanu, etc. were away on international duty.
Just to explain to everyone around the world, because they have a different system, but what happens is during internationals, teams can sign up short-term players.
Yep, sign up short-term players. Most of those players will be released after the players get back from international duty. As this one slips through from Salmon! Off the post! The crossbar, it bounces in! Ebony Salmon! Houston takes the lead.
She scored again, Ebony Salmon, absolutely brilliant. Look at that, 7 goals in 5 matches, stunning. So close for Michelle Beto. She gets a fingertip to it, gets it onto the crossbar, but it just crosses the line. and it's come good for Ebony Salmon at last. She hasn't really had much in the way of service, but they were getting more and more ball here, Houston Dash. They whip it in. It's not cleared at the near post. It's a clever little shot, and the goalkeeper for a second thought she had it there. Missed at the near post. She catches it beautifully, tipped onto the crossbar, and then just sneaks over the line. Brilliant from Ebony Salmon.
Yeah, you see just a tough break for Beto's there, and Ebony Salmon continues her hot streak. So she took a game off without scoring, and she's right back at it here against the Houston Dash.
I think it was Mandy Freeman who missed the ball at the front, at the near post. That's another error in defense that haunted them against OL Reign. It had to be cleared, and it wasn't, and they got punished. Lovely strike, Ebony Salmon, though.
Again, just to bring up this stat again, so now she has 7 goals since July 17th. That's just a month of playing games, and Ebony Salmon has 7 goals.
And I think it's in the last 5 matches that she scored those. I stand
yes.
corrected, but that's not a bad return. I mean, 2 of them were penalties, so 5 from open play in 5 matches, plus 2 penalties. Brilliant.
Nichelle Prince.
And it's tough on Gotham. They've played well. They've been defensively fairly solid. Just that one error there to allow that ball to come across the face of the goal to Ebony Salmon. At least Hugh Menzies has managed to improve the team and get them a lot tighter in defense so far.
Jacobs swerves off to Schmidt. Here comes Vigiano. Rips a shot, Vigiano scores! 2-0. Back-to-back goals for Houston.
That's a great strike from Vigiano, but nobody closed her down. She was looking to pass it out to the left. Nobody closed it down. She took it a bit further and eventually thought, you know what, why don't I have a dip? And she strikes it beautifully, just applauding the crowd there. Comes on as a sub and gets this goal, but again, space in the middle opening up. Now look what she does. She's got the ball. She's looking wide. Nobody comes. Nobody comes. Then she has a shot. What a good shot it is. Look, she's looking wide, trying to play it. And eventually turns, hooks it into the far corner.
Yeah, you could literally see her make the decision there. Wrestle with herself and say, all right. And Vigiano, again, 2 big strikes for Houston. And we were wondering if they were going to get shut out for 2 straight matches. Not the case at all.
And credit Juan Carlos Amorós. He made changes bang on halftime. He wanted to be on the front foot. Yes, of course, they've been helped by Mitch Purse being sent off. But the coach there had the intention to push his team forward. And eventually he's got his reward. Delighted to see Ebony Salmon scoring. But Vigiano is a surprise goal from her, her first of the season. What a lovely strike it was. Now, Gotham have to be careful not to completely collapse.
Well, Salmon wants a brace in the box. Off to Schmidt now. Schmidt lofts it up over the head of Beto's, and Beto's just barely at the back post, grabs it. So again, 2 goals in 3 minutes for Houston from Salmon and Vigiano. By the way, Vigiano was a halftime sub that was brought in. And again, Salmon's been playing this entire match, and we were wondering, you know, it did seem like some of the changes made at halftime provided her with just more touches. And of course, a heartbreaking turn of events for Gotham when Midge Purse picked up her 2nd yellow. And so Gotham has been playing without Purse and down a player for the majority of this second half.
Well, Houston Dash now, as long as they go on to win this game, will be joint top with Portland Thorns. Wonderful situation for Juan Carlos Amorós and his coaching team to be in.
Salmon. That's right into Estelle Johnson. Freeman, Sanchez. Salmon. Saved by Bike. Vigiano, aggressive.
A Well, you don't want to blame Mitch Purse for losing a match because she didn't lose it, but being sent, oh, here comes the goalkeeper again. You don't have to be out there. And if that's, that could be a judge, yep, yellow card.
Yellow card against Jane Campbell for coming out and tripping Paige Monahan.
She doesn't need to be out there. It's nothing to do with the goalkeeper. She's got defenders dealing with it. They're going away from, Paige Monahan's going away from goal. And under different circumstances, if you're the last line of defense, you get a red card for that. So I'm busy arguing with the referee as well. That's always dangerous. That could also be a second yellow. So Jane Campbell skating on thin ice there. But if she gets a shutout here, it'll tie her club record of 6 clean sheets in a season. And she'll also be fifth all-time with Ashlyn Harris. So goalkeeper's got some great records there.
We're seeing Taylor Smith come out and Cameron Tucker come in for Gotham. Tucker 23. And now a free kick for Gotham because of that, again, card given out to Jane Campbell. Mewis up, Zerboni taps it home. Gotham cuts the lead in half.
That's brilliant from Zerboni, getting in there where it counts most, using all her experience. You come back there and ask Jane Campbell the question, did you need to give that free kick away because you've been punished from it? And now they're back in the match, Gotham, but great spirit from Hugh Menzies' side here. Let's look at the ball whipped in. What a white shirt. It's looking like they might be in an offside position, but difficult to tell. And they're appealing, aren't they? Houston Dash are appealing, saying that there was definitely an offside there. But well done, Zerboni, dragging her team back into this match as a captain should.
Well, it is Zerboni's first goal since the season opener, the regular season opener. As we're seeing some subs, come in for Houston. See Nichelle Prince come out. Bazzali will come in. Farkason will also come in. So Callie Farkason comes in. Bree Bazzali comes in. And Nichelle Prince and Sophie Schmidt come out. So again, that Zerboni goal cuts the lead in half.
It gives them a lifeline, doesn't it?
Definitely does.
10 players have gotten, they're back in this game.
One thing to note is that this is not a Houston team that often gives up leads, and so we'll see how that plays out. But Gotham did score at the end of the OL Reign game, and I know that it had little to nothing to do with it, but then immediately went down and gave up an own goal. So obviously looking for a stronger response as they've got a lot of substitutes in like Cameron Tucker. But it won't be the eighth shutout for Gotham this year.
We saw Coach Hugh Menzies just shaking his head there, and he's probably just thinking, you know what, tough the sending off of Mitch Purse, tough with the first goal where Betos has tipped it onto the crossbar and has just crept over the line. They probably feel that they should be level in this game, and they should be level with players as well. So they've had a few tough breaks, but again, if they can come back and get a 2-2 draw from this game, it will show the character that's probably been missing from this side for a while.
Salmon Freeman gets out in front, clears. Now Jenna Bike. Moving through, trying to beat Garris. Off to Monahan. Corner.
Lovely play from Gotham from one end of the pitch to the other. And Jenna Bike doing really well there, bursting forward and helping Monahan into the corner. So could this be an equalizer from a set piece for Gotham?
Well, the last set piece worked out pretty well.
It did.
Monahan near post. Again, Zerboni has a lone score. It's up. Punched out by Campbell. And we got a whistle. Well, looks like a collision there with Monahan.
Monahan stepping back into Jane Campbell. The thing, if you're going to stand in front of a goalkeeper, you've got to make sure you don't make contact, you don't cause problems. You see her trying to step back, get in the goalkeeper's way. It used to be okay to do that, and I still think it should be, to be honest. But the moment you collide with a goalkeeper, get in the goalkeeper's face or body, you're likely to give away a free kick, and that's exactly what happened.
Here's a chance for Houston. Farquharson pulls it back. Again, just added for the dash. Jacobs off the body of Monahan. Again, that's her bony goal. Just gave this Gotham team some life. Down a player as her bony scored in the 80th minute.
There was some suspicion of offside from with that goal, but they got away with it, Gotham, and you wonder whether they couldn't have been a bit more on the front foot. Although expected goals-wise, and we did say that first half, they did have some really good chances with Onamanu. And their expected goals is higher than that. It's the first time in four games he's been in charge, the new coach, that anyone's had a higher expected goals than they have, which is a real surprise. So even that's something for Hugh Menzies to take away, is the way they've fought their way back into this match, the way they've created more opportunities than normal. They've been tighter in defense, except maybe that opening goal where they allowed it to get into the box and reach Ebony Salmon. But overall, I think much, much better performance by Gotham than we've seen for the last 7 or 8 games.
Yeah, this is night and day, absolutely. The OL Reign game felt, you know, shaky ground. New coach being announced a day before, obviously let Parkinson go. And so there's just a lot of chaos with that. This is a team that looks, you know, a lot better, a lot stronger. And, you know, there's still a chance. You see Billiter just directing traffic here because Houston's trying to waste some time in the corner.
It's always very frustrating when you're the team who wants to get on with the game, but it's a sensible thing to do if you're the team that is leading. Just work the clock down, keep the ball in the opposition half. So what they're managing to do, throw in after throw in. Of course, if you're Gotham, you want to get that ball down the other end of the pitch.
Well, again, we were scoreless until the 73rd minute in this match, and then Ebony Salmon scored, Vigiano scores 3 minutes later for Houston. Looks like they're going to run away with it, and then Zerboni, 4 minutes after that in the 80th minute, scores off a set piece for Gotham, and that's where we stand. It's been a late surge for both sides.
I think the difference is the type of goals. The one that Zerboni scored, difficult, you're defending from a set piece, a free kick, you try and play offside and it's not given and you're punished. But the goals that Gotham have given up, poor defending at the near post for one, allowing Vigiano to run right up to the edge of the box and shoot for the second as the ball comes for a goal kick for Michelle Batos. Both those goals, you look at it from a Gotham point of view and you go, scrappy, bad goals to give away.
Again, Ebony Salmon can't say enough about what she's done since being traded to Houston via Racing Louisville. It's been a fantastic fit. Of course, scored the first goal that really got things started for Houston. Here comes Gotham, though. Bike. Offside. We've seen that now 5 times for Gotham being offside.
Oh, some positive by Gotham here. I mean, yes, they are 2-1 down with a few minutes to go, so you expect them to have to throw things forward. But it shows you when they want to attack, they can be a decent offensive team.
Campbell. Back to Freeman, center back for Gotham.
Dash going to try and just keep them in their own half here. Lots of orange shirts. Look at them just trying to close it down, not allow Gotham to get forward into their half.
Mizawi. Just waits for it. Okay. Gotham ball. Bike earns it back for Gotham.
Okay, all the Dash players pushing up nice and tight. Look at the orange shirts in picture. Loads of them here just trying to box Gotham in.
Gene. Nice play by Farquharson. Just slows Gotham right now. Quick turnover from Uwis. Jacobs. We do approach stoppage time here in the second half. Again, 2-1 the score at PNC Stadium in Houston, Texas.
It's a change for the Dash. Looks like it just again slow things down. Take the energy out of Gotham.
Yeah, Ebony Salmon will come off. Michaela Abam will come in. And of course, Salmon gets a ton of applause from the home crowd here in Houston, deservedly so, with yet another goal. And Houston trying to pull off the season sweep of Gotham this year, already beat them July 31st. Monahan, offside, too good to be true.
They have played that offside trap very well, Houston Dash. They've caught Gotham out so many times, but the one time they didn't was from that free kick, and there's a lot of white shirts who looked like they could have been offside. But without the benefit of VAR and a replay, very difficult for referees to see what's going on there. And Zaboni gets the goal that gets Gotham back in this match, but it looks like they've done just about enough, Houston Dash, and that opening goal from Ebony Salmon, what a good finish it was. Nearly saved by Michelle Batos, but fantastic strike at the goalkeeper. Tips under the crossbar, and it just goes over the line.
Zerboni turns and fires. Why not? Paige Monahan on Prysock's back. Monahan gets tripped up. Otherwise, felt like a dangerous spot. Excuse me, that was Cameron Tucker. Vizali. Garris, we're going to get 7 minutes of stoppage time. Well, if you're Gotham, this definitely plays to your favor. Bike has been pretty explosive. Tucker offside.
Again, got to be a bit sharper up front. Gotham, you can't get caught time and time again from offside. Yes, they're playing it brilliantly. Houston Dash, give them credit. Nonetheless, you've got to be wise as a striker and just stay in a slightly onside position.
Freeman, clean takeaway. Now Zerboni. Johnson. Beatles will now pick it up. Johnson again. Freeman, just a chip. Right to Vigiano. Has a game winner at the moment. A slide to Sanchez. This will take us to the corner. And a foul.
Well played by Sanchez, did so well there. Just to slow it down and to win the foul. Now she can take a breather, work that clock down a little bit further. I just wonder what Mandy Freeman was doing there. She had the chance to boot the ball up the pitch. She stuck it up in the air, but only went forward about 10 yards, and immediately they were having to defend again. So lost opportunity from Mandy Freeman to try and get one over the back for her strikers. Always think when time is running out like this, your best to bang it down the field. Hope that there's a slip up from their defenders, that your striker gets a flick on maybe. So you don't have to have finesse at this stage of the game. It's just all about getting the ball down the other end of the pitch if you're Gotham.
Zerboni and Freeman have to back up a step. Billiter drew that line and they're a hair in front. As Bike had to step off. Again, Jenna Bike stepping off here for Gotham. So now they only have 9 players on the pitch. Vigiano. Houston ball. Mewis and company can't believe it.
Dash just strangling the game the professional way, slowing it down. So frustrating if you're a Gotham fan watching this. But this is the way to see out the match.
Ogle. Monahan up to defend. Well, Gotham earns it back. He's trying to get out of their own defensive end. Farkason, crucial. A bam, straight to the corner she goes.
It's a pity there that play wasn't knocked down the pitch. I think it was Ellie Jean who had the ball there. Instead of getting it down the pitch, knocking it long, she had the possession taken off her, and now Dash have got it back again, and they're just working the clock down. You see Jenna Bike trying to get a top on and get back in this game.
Yeah, must have been something on some sort of blood on the kit or something like that.
You would think.
Bike had to step off, gets a new kit, gets it cleaned off. And now back on urgently as we approach the end of this match. And for Gotham, the 7 minutes of stoppage time was a gift, but nothing has really come of it because, again, Bike had to leave, and so they've been playing with 9.
You do wonder what would have happened if Mitch Purse hadn't have got that second yellow. If she stays on this pitch, is it a different result? Possibly so. But nonetheless, I think Gotham fans all round will say this is a much better performance than they have seen from their team. Yes, they don't get any points, but the season's as good as done in terms of making the playoffs. They're not going to be able to do that, Gotham. What they can do is say, hey, we have a team better than our results, and we can start to build some confidence as we head towards the end of the season.
Vizali in the midfield. For Garris. All the way in the corner, wasting time. Freeman cleanly takes it away. And now Torres just can't get through Sanchez. Perhaps some of the exhaustion catching up with Gotham.
Well, they're trying to play out. When I think just boot it long, boot it down the pitch. You don't have to play through, nice football and play through everyone. You want to get to the other end and try and score. And they haven't been able to do that, as Juan Carlos Amoros points to his watch and says, time up.
Well, he's trying to get win number 4 of 5 games played, and he does. So back to their winning ways. Houston, after drawing against Racing Louisville, continues the unbeaten streak. It's now 5 games for Houston without a loss, and all under Amoros.
4 wins and a draw. So the two coaches shake hands, and well done to Hugh Menzies and Zerboni. They put up a really good fight. Not much more they could do. And again, we'll go back to that Mitch Purse second yellow and say that clearly was a big turning point in the match, and maybe ultimately cost Gotham a chance of getting any points.
Well, Gotham, again, a much better showing, but now, again, continuing to lose games. So lost 8 of their last 9. And just, you know, Menzies and company looking for improvement and certainly saw it today.
Yep. Better times ahead, perhaps, for Gotham. They've got a few more matches coming up in the next few weeks, and hopefully they'll get some better results. They've got Orlando home, Angel City home, Courage home. In fact, I think they've got 4 home matches to come. So based on what we've seen today, I think those home matches should produce much better performances for the Gotham fans.
Well, that will do it from us here in Houston. Again, final score 2-1, a victory for the Houston Dash over Gotham FC. From Gary Bailey, I'm Maura Sheridan saying so long. Have a great night, everyone.